Hey, everybody, and welcome to Collider's 20 Most Anticipated Films of 2016. I'm Ashley Mova, and here with me are Steve Weintraub and John Campia.
And you know, we are so excited for the films that have already been announced for 2016. We got some great-looking blockbusters, some great-looking indies. This list you're going to get is filled with both of them.
With all these amazing movies coming out in 2016, everyone at Collider put together their most anticipated list, and here are the tabulated results.
And without further ado, here are Collider's top 20 most anticipated movies of 2016. First up is honorable mention, The Jungle Book.
Iron Man director Jon Favreau's newest incarnation of a young boy's story who was raised in the jungle, not named Tarzan, was flying under the radar for most people until it was the talk of Disney's D23 convention, which had the whole audience buzzing. The film looks absolutely spectacular and actually tied for 20th spot on our list, but due to a tiebreaker, it fell out. But we still felt it deserved a mention.
Number 20, Midnight Special. A boy with special powers is at the center of director Jeff Nichols' new film. The March release stars Nichols' staple performer Michael Shannon, as well as Joel Edgerton, Kirsten Dunst, and Adam Driver. Midnight Special opens in theaters on March 18th.
You know, the last film that Jeff put out in theaters was Mud, starring Matthew McConaughey. If that's not enough to get you excited about this movie, nothing will be. And the film he did with Michael Shannon, Take Shelter, won the Critic Grand Prize Award at the Cannes Film Festival. At number 19, The BFG. Steven Spielberg is in charge of adapting this beloved children's lore to the big screen. He directs a movie where a girl, a queen, and a big friendly giant, hence the name, must stop a horde of man-eating giants from taking over. It's live action, but the vocal talents of Bill Hader and Jermaine Clement will be on display as giants. The BFG himself is voiced by Mark Rylance from Bridge of Spies, also directed by Steven Spielberg. The BFG opens in theaters on July 1st.
Number 18, Triple Nine. With a cast including Woody Harrelson, Chiwetel Ejiofor, Aaron Paul, Norman Reedus, and an unrecognizable Kate Winslet, Triple Nine is a dark action thriller involving crooks, corrupt cops, and a big heist. The Rhodes' John Hillcoat directs a film whose trailer will have your pulse pounding. We don't have to wait too long as the film opens wide early in the year on February 26th.
John Hillcoat is one of the best directors that nobody has ever heard of. On top of The Road, he's also directed The Proposition with Guy Pearce and Lawless, really underrated by the way, with Tom Hardy, Gary Oldman, and Jessica Chastain.
Number 17, The Witch. Promising young talent Robert Eggers directs this dark tale that has already made a splash at Sundance. When the infant son of a 17th century New England family goes missing, it appears the eldest daughter is to blame. However, more sinister forces could be at work, making The Witch an early candidate to be the scariest film of the year.
This is one of those films that opened at Sundance, getting rave reviews from everyone that saw it.
Number 16, Everybody Wants Some. Director Richard Linklater follows up his award season sensation Boyhood with this spiritual sequel to Dazed and Confused. That was a story about high school football. Now we get a college baseball team set in the early 1980s. Featuring a cast of young up-and-comers, Everybody Wants Some should have a mix of drama and comedy that is right in the director's wheelhouse. Everybody Wants Some opens in theaters on April 15th.
Number 15, Warcraft. The game that to some is a relationship-ending addiction now gets a big screen adaptation with Moon and Source Code director Duncan Jones at the wheel. War is imminent in a sprawling universe where orcs battle humans. The real fight will be between good versus evil. Fans hope the heavy dose of performance capture can look realistic enough to transport them to a world they've always dreamed of seeing. Warcraft opens on June 10th.
It's seen as the film that could finally fulfill the promise of a good video game movie. Adding stars like Dominic Cooper, Ben Foster, and Paula Patton to a director like Jones only increases that potential.
Number 14, Doctor Strange. Marvel hopes to dominate the fall box office when the mysterious Doctor Strange hits theaters. Benedict Cumberbatch stars as a man who gains dark powers after a debilitating tragedy. Horror director Scott Derrickson has an impressive ensemble to work with, including Oscar-winning actresses Tilda Swinton and Oscar nominee Chiwetel Ejiofor. In addition, rumors abound of other Marvel heroes swinging by. Spider-Man, anyone? Doctor Strange opens on November 4th.
Now, this will absolutely be the most unique Marvel film we've had to date. Guardians of the Galaxy took us into space. Now, Doctor Strange takes us into the mystical. Number 13, Assassin's Creed. The Templar organization better look out. Calum Lynch is out to stop them, and he's played by none other than Magneto Jobs, Michael Fassbender. A descendant of the mysterious society, the Assassins, Lynch's most surprising feat may be simply existing in a film that is finally happening. Video game films have not impressed their diehard fans to date, but maybe a cast that also involves Marion Cotillard, Jeremy Irons, and Brendan Gleeson can help turn the tide. Assassin's Creed opens in December 31st.
If past performance is anything to go by, the trio of director Justin Kurzel, Michael Fassbender, and Marion Cotillard also all worked together on this year's Macbeth to strong critical reviews.
Number 12, Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. Oscar winner Eddie Redmayne plays a magic zoologist in the same world where Harry Potter casts spells. However, this film takes place 70 years before the boy wizard ever picks up a wand. Colin Farrell and Ezra Miller will also star, and Potter alum David Yates is directing the J.K. Rowling story. Landing just before Thanksgiving, Fantastic Beasts is positioned to be the family hit of the holiday season. Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them opens on November 18th.
Can they capture that magic again? Will the Potter fandom follow J.K. over to this new story? Lots of intriguing questions. Number 11, Ghostbusters. Who are you gonna call? Four entirely new Ghostbusters in a different universe than the previous franchise. Melissa McCarthy joins SNL veterans Kristen Wiig, Kate McKinnon, and Leslie Jones as the supernatural peacekeepers. The movie lands right in the middle of summer, a season that has been very good to Spy and Bridesmaids director Paul Feig. Ghostbusters opens on July 15th.
Number 10, Nice Guys. From Iron Man 3 director Shane Black comes this 1970s-based film starring Ryan Gosling and Russell Crowe as a mismatched pair. Their investigation of the disappearance of a girl and the death of a porn star promises an unlikely comedic turn for the actors, and Black seems to be back in his kiss-kiss-bang-bang form. Nice Guys opens on May 20th.
The trailer came out of nowhere and floored a lot of people. Russell Crowe is one of the best in the business, and Gosling is one of Hollywood's hottest right now. On top of that, while the film was being made here in Los Angeles, I got to visit the set with a few other people. All of us on set were laughing hysterically. One of these movies that all of us can't wait to see.
Number 9, Silence. We'll probably never see Andrew Garfield swing from buildings again, but starring in a Martin Scorsese film isn't a bad alternative. Also featuring Liam Neeson and Adam Driver, the movie centers on two Jesuit priests who travel to Japan to seek out their Christian mentor.
Number 8, Bourne 5. While we wait for an official title for the latest installment of the thrilling spy franchise, we can rest easy knowing that Matt Damon is back as Jason Bourne. After a one-film detour that starred Jeremy Renner as another lab rat in the Treadstone Project, Damon returns, and so does director Paul Greengrass, who also helmed The Bourne Supremacy and The Bourne Ultimatum.
Now, The Bourne Legacy honestly wasn't really all that bad, but it did really make us miss the one true, authentic, real Jason Bourne, which is Matt Damon. Not to mention, unlike the last couple of films, they have actually got a working script on this one that they're all looking forward to shooting.
Number 7, X-Men Apocalypse. Everyone's favorite mutants face their biggest challenge ever, literally. The monstrous Apocalypse shows up to bestow his terrifying power upon four worthy recipients, and it's up to Professor X and the team to stop him. James McAvoy, Michael Fassbender, Jennifer Lawrence, and director Bryan Singer all return from the smash success of X-Men Days of Future Past. But will the character of Apocalypse be able to please fans who have so far been skeptical of his big screen look? X-Men Apocalypse opens in theaters on May 27th.
Bryan Singer has never done anything less than excellent X-Men films. The original, X2, and of course, most recently, Days of Future Past were all exceptional, and now he's working with one of the most beloved and feared villains in the property. We should expect nothing but great things from this film. Number 6, Deadpool. The ad campaign alone has propelled this superhero flick into our top 10. Surprising, considered that star Ryan Reynolds played the Merc with a Mouth before to less than desirable results in the disappointing X-Men Origins Wolverine. But a fresh start and an R rating has fans hoping that this time, Fox got it right. If the trailers are any indication, this February release will hit us right in our sweet spot. What a lovely Valentine's Day gift indeed. Deadpool opens on February 12th.
It's the definition of a passion project. Ryan Reynolds and director Tim Miller have been working on this movie for 7 years, trying desperately to make Deadpool the movie that all of us think it can be. Number 5, Suicide Squad. The first DC Cinematic Universe film to follow up Batman v Superman gives us a plan just crazy enough to work as a gaggle of bad guys team up in a deadly secret mission sanctioned by the government. Will Smith and Margot Robbie lead the ragtag team in their mission, and Jared Leto gets the chance to put a new spin on the Joker. The prospect of all these villains let loose has us almost as excited as David Ayer was at Comic-Con this past summer. Suicide Squad opens on August 5th.
Now this is a big gamble for DC. Following up a movie like Batman v Superman with a cast of basically unknown characters to the average film fan, they're hoping that they can capture whatever magic and whatever lightning in a bottle Marvel caught with Guardians of the Galaxy. So far, fans are reacting really well to the trailers.
Number 4, Batman vs. Superman, Dawn of Justice. Man of Steel set up the events that will transpire in a movie that sees a new Batman hit the big screen. Ben Affleck, who dons the cape and cowl as Bruce Wayne, is forced out of retirement by his perception of an alien threat in the form of Superman. The two will duke it out right up until the end, unless a bigger threat emerges. Gal Gadot's Wonder Woman makes her big screen debut as well. Batman vs. Superman opens on March 25th.
It's almost unreal to think that these two icons have never appeared on the big screen together. Man of Steel may have kicked things off, but this is the film that's going to give us our true taste of what the DC Cinematic Universe is actually going to be.
At number three, Hail Caesar. The Coen brothers are back, and with them is a cast full of A-listers. When a Golden Age Hollywood top actor gets kidnapped, a fixer has to step in and make it right. George Clooney, Josh Brolin, Channing Tatum, and Scarlett Johansson star in a film that will also feature supporting turns by Tilda Swinton, Ralph Fiennes, and Jonah Hill. Hail Caesar opens on February 5th.
The Coen brothers' filmography reads like a who's who of cool Hollywood films, from Raising Arizona, No Country for Old Men, The Big Lebowski, Fargo, Oh Brother Where Art Thou, and on and on. The Coen brothers are some of the best filmmakers working in the business. We cannot wait to see this film. Number two, Captain America Civil War. Yes, Cap is the headliner, but virtually the entire cast of the Avengers will be returning to do battle in this installment. Plus, this summer release will give us our first look at Black Panther and the new Spider-Man. A rift between Captain America and Tony Stark will force their mighty brethren to choose sides, and it's also the Russo brothers' chance to set up the Avengers Infinity War films. Captain America Civil War opens on May 9th.
The Russo brothers came out of virtually nowhere to give us what some say is the best Marvel film to date in Captain America Winter Soldier. Marvel has handed the virtual keys to the kingdom to these two guys. Let's see how they run with it.
And number one, Rogue One, A Star Wars Story. Star Wars is officially back, but now Disney wants to take the landscape beyond their Skywalker episodes. Director Gareth Edwards takes on the challenge of the first anthology film, surrounding a small band of rebels daring to steal the plans to the Death Star from the Galactic Empire. Felicity Jones, Forest Whitaker, and Mads Mikkelsen star in a movie that still has us wondering if any classic characters might pop in. Paging Darth Vader! Rogue One opens on December 16th.
Lucasfilm has done the near impossible. They successfully relaunched the Star Wars franchise, breaking every record of the book and smashing almost every expectation. Star Wars is once again on a very healthy road. I absolutely love this list, and I cannot wait to see almost every single one of these films. Couple surprises though. We had a whole bunch of us at Collider put in our votes to make this list. I'm a little bit heartbroken that Jon Favreau's Jungle Book didn't make it on the list. I had it kind of high on mine. Also, one that I had on my list that did not appear in our finals was John Wick 2. I'm really excited, and I never would have thought that. Prior to seeing the first John Wick, another Keanu Reeves kind of throwaway low-budget film, was my total surprise movie of the year. I love that film. Cannot wait to see the second one. What stood out to you about this list?
I think this list is actually really, really well done, and I think that... all of them are movies that all of us are super excited
Absolutely.
To see.
Absolutely.
I think the big thing is that there's going to be a few surprises, that films that we haven't really heard of that are going to be added to, you know, 2016
that haven't been
release.
Announced for the year yet.
Exactly. Yeah. And those are going to be the ones that I think are going to come out of left field, that we're all going to be raving about, but aren't on the list yet because it hasn't been dated or they haven't been officially released for 2016.
One other surprise one to me that did not make it on the list was, I didn't have it on mine, but I still expected it to be on the final one, which was Star Trek Beyond. I really kind of thought it might pop up there, noticeable by its absence.
Here's the thing, no matter what we put on this list, there's gonna be 10 films and other people are gonna be like, yeah, like how did you, and by the way, it didn't even hit me till just now that Star Trek's not on the list, but that's easily in my top 20 of the year. It's impossible. It's for now.
When you have it as short as 20, there's always going to be good ones to get left off.
Yes.
Well, there you have it, guys. Collider's 20 most anticipated films of 2016.
There's a lot of honorable mentions that almost made this list, but right now we want to hear from you. What films on this list are you most excited to see? We want you to leave comments in the space below.
So listen, while you're here, why don't you take a second and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Following Collider Video will keep you up to date on everything we got going on over here. And while you're at it, make sure you go over and bookmark Collider.com. Steve and his crack team of writers doing an excellent job of keeping you up to date by the minute of everything going on in the world of entertainment. So for Ashley Mova, Steve Weintraub, and myself, John Campia, thank you to you guys for joining us. Make sure you leave a comment, and we'll see you next time.